Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Yesterday night round 7 of Syncfeed Cup 2018 was played. All the 5 matches were drawn, so Caruana remains the sole leader of the tournament. But today we have the interesting match Cards and Caruana to review together. Before we start with the analysis, don't forget to subscribe to the channel because I cover all the most important chess tournaments. And now let's start with the game. E4, E5 for Caruana. Knight in f3, knight in f6, the Petrov's defense that is Caruana's favorite. Knight capture in 5, d6, attacking the knight comebacks in f3, knight capture in 4, knight in c3, knight capture in c3, attacking the queen, d capture in c3, and bishop in e7. Now bishop in e3, knight in c6, because black doesn't want to castle now, because doesn't want to give so soon a target for white attack. Bishop in c4, Carlsen develops the bishop before playing queen in d2, because generally white will castle alongside. Now castle, queen in d2, bishop in f5, long castle for white, and queen in d7 for black, and so we see that both players complete their development. King in b1, this is almost always a useful move before starting the operations on the king side. Rook in f goes in e8, h4 starts the attack, bishop in f8 that will defend the castle, h5, h6 now. Bishop in e2, and it's a normal move, but it seems more natural to play rook in d goes in g1. Now bishop in g4, knight in c4 attacking the bishop, but bishop capture in e2, queen capture in e2, and after knight in e5, black equalized the game. Bishop in c1. Caruana activates the king in c6, also attack the pawn in g2, f4, good move, that attacks the knight and also open the protection from the queen. The knight goes in c4, queen in d3, and Caruana plays queen in e4 with the idea to exchange queens. g4 now. The intermediate move is knight in e3 attacking the rook moves in e1, now the queen is changed in d3, c recapture in d3, knight in d5, and now the rook in g1. Rook in e6, with the idea to protect this h6 pawn, maybe an improvement is instead of playing rook in e6 is to put the rook in e2, but as we said, Caruana wants the rook here to protect the castle. g5, attacking the h6, knight in e7, computer suggests king in h7, but really this position are quite difficult also to both to attack and both to defend. G capture in h6. Now we see why Caruana put the rook there, because he recapture with the rook. F5, rook in h7, knight in g4, the king moves away from the action of this rook. F6 now, not g capture in f6, because after knight capture, rook in g7, rook in f1, white becomes much better. So after f6, the knight goes in g8, f capture in g7 we check, rook capture, and let's come back. It seems also possible to capture with the bishop, but after h6, the bishop in f6 seems less passive, a bit better than comeback in f8. Knight in f2, rook in e8, Knight in e4, bishop in e7, and bishop in e3, after bishop in e3, with the idea, of course, to play the terrible bishop in d4. The black player must play c5, but in this variation, white has the edge. So it's better to play rook capture in g7, because now h6 is not powerful like before, because the rook can go in g6. So after rook capture in g7, bishop in e3, again c5 to protect the d4 square, bishop in f4, the rook in e8 to control the e-file, knight in e3, rook capture in g1, rook capture in g1, and rook in e6. Knight in d5, knight in f6, knight in c7, attacking the rook. The rook is very well positioned here in e2. Now, knight in b5, attacking the pawn, and the rook comes back in e6. Now, at this point, both players have little time on the clock. Carlsen just 1 minute, 1 minute and 20 seconds, if I'm not wrong, and Caruana almost 4 minutes. In this position, it's possible for White to capture in a7 after king in h8, that is useful to later play the bishop here in h6. Rook in h1, knight in d5 attacking the bishop, bishop in c1, sorry, and bishop in h6. Black seems to hold comfortably, and more than that, there is no time to find the right plan. So that's why after rook in e6, Carlsen play rook in f1, and after king in g8, knight in c7, rook in e2, Carlsen goes for the repetition. Again, knight in b5, rook in e6, knight in c7, rook in e2, knight in b5 again, rook in e6, and it's a draw. And with this move, we also end our commentary. I hope that you like this game, and if you did, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, because I have many, many more great games to show you. For now, thanks for watching, and goodbye.